These men stood before the most powerful man in the known universe at that day. Because remember, in the book of Daniel, he is that head of gold. He is that head of gold in Nebuchadnezzar's dream. And they stand before this king, and they tell this king that we don't have to think about it. We don't have to have a prayer meeting about it. We don't have to have a conference call about it. We are not going to bow down to your image because we love God, and if God wants to save us, he'll do so. But be it known to you, O king, we respect you. That's not the issue, but we respect God even more. Amen. And because of that, the Bible says he was bound up. They were bound up, all three young men. They were bound up. They were bound up in all of their clothes. And the Bible says that the king was so angry. He was so upset. He was so mad because someone stood up to him and said no to him. And he said, you know what? I'm going to deal with you. Now look, the furnace was hot enough to burn already. But now he says, and this is the furnace that he probably used to build that 90-foot high image and 9-foot wide image for everybody to bow down to. So it was plenty hot already, but this man is so angry. He is so upset. He is so beside himself. He is so mad at these young men that he says, heat up the furnace 7 times hotter. We're going to make quick work of you right now. The furnace was so hot that the Bible says that the heat from it, that the flames from it burned the men that carried them to the furnace. Isn't that interesting? It was so hot. He was so angry. He wanted to get rid of them so bad. And Satan is like that with you and I. Satan wants to get rid of you. Satan, the Bible says in the book of John, chapter 10, verse 10, Jesus said that the thief comes to steal, to kill, and destroy. Mm-hmm. He wants to steal from you. And then he wants to kill you. And then he wants to destroy you utterly from this earth. Because let me tell you something. When you and I die, Satan is really not concerned about us. Why? Because if you're in heaven, he doesn't deal with you. If you choose not to accept Jesus as your Lord and your Savior while you're alive on this earth, you will go to hell. There's just no bottom line. There's no ifs, ands, or buts about it. There is no such thing as purgatory. You don't get a chance to think about it. You either make the choice while you're here on this earth, or when you die, you will go to hell. And in hell, of course, Satan doesn't care about you because he will torment you. Who is Satan concerned about? Satan is concerned about the man or the woman of God that is on the earth, that lives for God and walks by faith, because that is the person that is his enemy. You're not his enemy when you're in heaven or when you're in hell. You're his enemy while you are on this earth and you accept Jesus as your personal Savior and Lord, and then you walk by the precepts of the Bible, and when you walk by the precepts of the Bible, the anointing is on you, the power is on you. You can do great and mighty exploits. Even when it looks like you have nothing, God will multiply what you have and it will confound everybody. How in the world are you able to do that? How in the world are you able to live the way you live and you have no job? How in the world are you able to do this? How in the world are you able to be a millionaire and you have no degree? How in the world are you able to do these things? Praise God. Because God is an awesome God. He is a multiplier. When Jesus took the loaves of bread and the pieces of fish, it was not enough to feed 20,000 people. The Bible says it was 5,000 men, but the men had their wives with them and the men had their children with them. So it was nearly 20,000 people, and Jesus gave thanks to it, and supernaturally he was able to feed the multitude of families that were present there with him. Jesus loves you, and Jesus will not allow you to do without. But you have to trust him, you have to be thankful, and you got to go through even when you don't want to go through. Amen.